just for kicks. How's that, motherfucker?
Motherfucker? That's actually great, motherfucker. Hope you are doing well. Obviously, I'm late again this week. I told you I wouldn't be, or I said I would try not to be. Defend me here. I am a little late. I apologize for that. It's been a little crazy with the schedule. By the way, guys, you're here at Camping Them Softly. We're at episode, and I know because I looked this up. Actually, we are at episode number 23. Yeah. Oh, guys, by the way, man, we are just right at 7 months old, actually, because we started on January 12th. And I mean, look at where we are now. It's unbelievable. I'm going to have to turn it up. Yeah, 7 months. 7 months. It's so stupid. I'm sorry. That's dumb. Most everybody has left by now. But yeah, that's it. It's crazy, though. It's bananas to me that this is as big as it is and that it's getting bigger. Like, that's what's wild to me. I thought maybe, like, people be like, I'll fucking listen to it for about 10 minutes and then just fucking, like, who gives a shit, right? And it just keeps going and going and going and going. I don't even know what... I don't know what the fuck's happening half of the time. Approximately half of the time, I have no idea what's going on. And actually, now that I look at it, because, you know, I always get on whenever you know, the stream starts. I start to look because I'm nosy, right? I got to know what the fuck's going on. Like, what do you guys want to hear about, right? And that's, like, normal. I think that's what people do. I would assume that that's what they do. And the downloads, man, are coming and coming and coming. And the places, by the way, are getting weirder and weirder and weirder. And I don't know. Like, it boggles the mind that people in the most remote parts of the world decide, hey, guess what? I'm going to listen to this douchebag. I'm going to spend time out of my fucking day to see what this asshole's doing. And that just, like, I don't know. Like, it's wild. It's wild. But, hey, I want to tell you, I appreciate it. Like, I don't know what I did yesterday, but I had a rash of downloads, like a deluge, like a tsunami of downloads out of nowhere. I have no clue what it was, because just out of the sudden, just bam, like a ton of them. And it wasn't like, it wasn't a normal amount. It was more than triple what happened the day before. I didn't even do anything yesterday. Like, I didn't advertise. I didn't go out and, like, hey, fucking, like, I didn't buy airtime. It just happens. That's the way it is with me, man. Somebody at work, I was telling them about it. And I was telling, you know, the geography part. I'm always talking about that. You know, I bore you guys to death with it. I was telling him about it. And he was like, dude, you're Mr. fucking Worldwide. And then somebody said, well, apparently there's already somebody with that name. It's like Pitbull or something. Does anyone know who Pitbull is? Is that a person? That's a singer, right? And apparently they say I look like Pitbull if I put sunglasses on, because he's got as much hair as I do. And so I found that offensive and I punched him in the face and I kept walking. I mean, it is a workplace after all. I'm not going to do anything else. So... there's that. No, so let's get back. We need some applause. I said that sentence started to run on a little too long. You ever do that? Like, I had that happen today, actually, where you're standing there and you're having a great conversation with somebody, right? Like, you're like, it's hilarious. You're banging on all cylinders. It's just a coworker conversation. And you are just, I'm fucking, in the words of Jen Z or Gen Alpha. I don't even know which fucking gen it is anymore. I am slaying, okay? I could not be funnier. I should sell tickets to the conversation that I was having. But then, do you ever have it where that conversation stretches out just a little too long and it kind of dies that slow death where you're just like, well, all right, I'll see you later. Like, I'll go to my desk. It's right over there, just in case you were wondering and you haven't been by my desk 27 times.
Shut up, bitch.
And yeah, that's what happened. So that was my day. And hopefully you guys have had a good past few days as well. I've rambled on for well over 5 minutes about goddamn nothing. And one thing that actually is something is I got this new like fucking soundboard. Like, I've got so many different things with 27 fucking buttons on my toxic desk here. I'm having a hard time keeping up with them all. And I know the past few episodes, the sounds have been a little inconsistent. Some of the sound effects have been loud. Some have been soft. Some have been in the middle. So that's what I'm working on, and I'm using this new fucking thing. I figured out, here was the hard part, because I got 7 billion fucking sound effects. Like 6,999,000 I never even use. I've never used them. I put them in a sound effects folder, and I forget about them. The thing is, they're all fucking different volumes. So some of them blow your fucking eardrum out, and the other ones you can't even hear. So I was like, you know what? Let's ask Samuel AI Jackson what he would do. And of course, he gave me the answer. He gave me, here's how you batch modify the sound of different sound effects and then export them out and then, you know, whatever. So now I've got fucking all of my sound effects should be about the same. And I've got shit like I didn't even name them correctly. So I don't know what they are. So forgive me. I want to see what the, I don't even know.
You're a nothing, a nobody, a peon to the rock.
Oh, it's a rock one. Okay, that's cool. I'll take that. What is this one? It just says play to win. Hang on. Play to win. Here we go. Let me see what this sounds like.
Very competitive person, but I want to tell you something right now. I play to win.
Oh, he plays to win, guys. Just FYI. Oh, that one. Okay.
Very competitive person, but I want to tell you something right now.
I accidentally played it twice. He does play to win. He plays to win twice. Okay. All right. Still going down the list here. I got like fucking horse smelling is one. I'm getting scared the further down I go.
You shit kicking stinky horseman horse smelling motherfucker, you.
Okay, that one's gonna go in the I have like a little folder of like keep, and that's gonna go in the keep one. What's Hox? HOX01. Okay, I don't even know. What ignorant SOB. Oh, good Lord.
You stupid, ignorant son of a bitch, dumb bastard.
Okay, that's going in the keep. Insane.
Maybe I am insane. Maybe I am insane. And maybe it's time for you to find out how insane I am. Yeah.
Okay, that's going in the keep. I've got a Jeopardy one. That's good. Yeah, there we go. And then we got some.
You got some kick ass shit.
That's one of the main ones. If you've ever been on here, you know that one. Oh, this one I used to use actually.
You're being a little bitch.
Yeah, you are being. That came from Fox Business, by the way, like the TV station. Somebody on Fox Business actually said that. And somehow it ended up on my, what is this, cockroach mouth?
For me, you're somewhere between a cockroach and that white stuff that accumulates at the corner of your mouth when you're really thirsty.
Okay, crap.
What in the hell is this crap?
Oh, dude, I love that. I love that one. And then what's...
Am I dreaming or is that you, Harrington?
Yeah, it's me. Don't cream your pants.
Okay, that one obviously I'm going to keep. And then do not, is this do not go in there, the Ace Ventura?
Do not go in there. Woo!
Okay, yeah. See, that one I know myself well enough to know what that is. The only one I don't see on here, do I have the one for my survivors? I don't know that. Oh, God. No, I have to have it, though. Oh, shit. Okay, I'm going to have to get that. I think I've got it on another one, though, that I'm going to have to have that one handy because we're going to be talking about them a little bit here in a while. Let's see. I'm kind of discombobulated. Is this it right here? Well, oh, shit. It's not working now. Oh, fucking shit on a shingle. Let me see. I got you. You just shut your fucking mouth right now. That's it right there. I actually have to do something real quick. If you'll shut up for a second so I can put that on my thing. Because I'm going to have that like at hand. It has to be at hand. And yes, whenever I say at hand means I need to have it right here. So guys, anyway, let's talk. While I'm doing this, I'm going to try to do two things at once. We're going to go over like some 2v8 stuff today. We're also going to talk about, obviously, the geography. Where are his listeners from? I don't give a fuck. Can he just shut up? Well, guess what, Survivor? Okay, it's working. Great, great. Guess what, Survivor? We're going to talk about it because that's what I fucking like to talk about. And we do what I want to do on this show. That is quite loud, and I love it. So, without further ado, let's go to the viewers. Dude, I need to, you know what I need to do? I just come up with an AI jingle of like, where his fucking viewers from, motherfucker. You know, something like that. And then we've got one. I can even do one for like the theme, like, you know, this is his fucking theme song. Like, hang on. It's toxic. Hang on. I am typing it now, the jingle. It's toxic. Camping them softly. Where his fucking viewers from? Fucking with an apostrophe, even. Where his fucking viewers from? We're about to fucking find out. Are they from the United States or fucking Ireland? Fucking Ireland. What rhymes with Ireland? Or fucking Ireland. Hang on. Yeah, check it out. We've got there's too much happening here. See, this is the essence of this podcast. I did not have any of this planned out. I have like four tabs open about shit to talk about, no notes whatsoever, and then I go here. So this is what you've got. So just sit back and fucking either enjoy the ride or get off the fucking bus, whatever.
You gotta give him that huck too and spit on that thing.
Yes, and I know that joke is old and it's sticking around. It's going to stick around. Pretend you are Samuel L. Jackson and curse in every sentence. Tell me what it rhymes with Ireland. Okay, there we go. Are they from the United States or fucking Ireland or maybe Ireland? Oh, hang on.
Well, you came to the right damn place. You want something that rhymes with Ireland? How about Highland? Or maybe Island. Hell, I'll even throw in Vineland just for kicks. How's that, motherfucker?
Motherfucker? That's actually great, motherfucker. So can we do Island? I don't know if anyone was from the islands, though. There had to be an island. Well, Australia's an island, right? Oh, yeah. Or fucking Ireland. Are they from, oh, where was somebody else? I'm trying to think of some of our other listeners. Oh, no, are they from Sao Paulo or the Australian island? There we go. Who fucking knows? Who fucking knows? Question mark. Who fucking cares? What rhymes with cares now? Hairs? Layers. This is how music happens, people. This is music in action.
Give me a hell yeah. What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. Oh, that'll amp you up, man. That's stone cold. Like, we are all over the place. I want to apologize to those of you who are sane. Okay. I'm going to offer you an apology. You should not be here right now. I am recording. It is very late at night and I'm up. I am up, up, up. So you should also be up, or if you're driving or if you have children, like, you know, turn me off. Turn me off. What was I doing? Oh, yes. Who fucking cares? Okay. Now what? Stay in character. I'm going to say stay in character from here on. Tell me what rhymes with cares. Boom. Nailed it. Okay. Here we go. And
you want rhymes for cares? I got you, motherfucker.
Whoa!
Stairs, flares, bears, wares, and even affairs. How's that for a list, huh?
Stairs, flares, bears, wares, and even affairs. Hang on. Give me more. Give me some more. I don't know if any of you guys know that song. Okay, here we go.
You want more, huh? All right, here you go. Glare, airs, pairs, shares, snares, and even repairs.
Okay.
I'm dropping these rhymes like they're hot, motherfucker.
Motherfucker! Wacker! Oh, I love it. Say it again, Sam.
You want more, huh? All right, here you go. Glare, airs, pairs, shares, snares, and even repairs.
Here he comes.
I'm dropping these rhymes like they're hot, motherfucker.
What? Motherfucker! And none of you, I guarantee you, none of your asses got that Casablanca reference I threw in there. See, this is genius. This is a genius fucking podcast. And you're here. This is free. You're getting it for free. And that's a shame, really. It is a shame because someday I'm going to be broke. I'm going to be like, I can't fucking afford this. And then I'm going to drop off the face of the earth. And you're going to be like, how am I going to know who downloaded this week? Is it fucking Reykjavik? Is it fucking West Noosa Tangara? We'll never know if they ever came back. Hint, they have not come back yet. Okay, so what were we on? Snares, shares, dares. Okay, who fucking knows? Who fucking cares? Let's see. Toxic does because he's a badass. Okay, does because he's a badass. And camping them softly is the podcast. Oh, shit. See, I wrote myself into a corner. Is the podcast with snares? With stairs? Affairs? World affairs. Can I do global affairs? Is a podcast of global affairs? Oh, that sounds terrible. That sounds awful. Who fucking knows? Okay, do like a jingle, like a podcast intro jingle. Okay, that's what I put. Are they from? But it's Toxic Teacher. Okay, hang on. We're getting there. It's the Toxic Motherfucking Teacher. You know what? I could say it's a Toxic Mother. Are they from the United States? Fucking Ireland. Are they from Sao Paulo? Are they fucking Australia? We need to get some more fucks in there. Who fucking knows? Who fucking cares? All right, here we go. And then we're going to make it. This is going to take like 10 seconds. By the way, dude, I made another song and I was just goofing around, dude. And I'm making fucking AI gold here. And it just like I'm banging on all cylinders. I don't know how I do it. I just know that I do it. And I was putting in funky, like, you know how you just sit there? Do you ever just sit there? And you just like sing to yourself, right? And you're just like fucking singing dumb shit. I don't know if you do it. I do. Like, motherfucker. Da, 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 da. Like, shit like that, you know? Like, you're just standing there. Somebody trying to talk to you about something. You're motherfucker. Da, 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 da. Like something like that, right? And so I just started typing in whatever came to mind. And I'm a fucking genius. That's all I got to say is I am a genius. And I need some kind of award. I don't know what kind of awards they give, but I fucking deserve it. So let me just, this is wild, dude, because I was just putting toxic teacher. That's like, and then I just put like synth heavy new wave music, right? That was it. That, and it fucking took it in a wildly different direction. It may be loud, but fuck you. Deal with it. Oh yeah, check it. Dude, it's so fucking German. It's like wild. It's the most German thing I've ever created. It's just my name over and over again. I think. See, I got like a fucking thing there. Oh yeah, there we go. Okay. Now we're back. We're back to normal volume now. Normal volume podcast. Oh, my jingle's done. See, look at this. Look how fast this is. I don't know what it's gonna sound like, but remember, we made the lyrics together here. It's a toxic teacher camping them softly. Where are the fucking viewers from? We're about to fucking find out. Are they from the United States or fucking Ireland? Are they from Sao Paulo or the fucking Australian island? See, this is genius. Who fucking knows? Who fucking cares? Toxic does, because he's a badass, and Camping Them Softly is the podcast of global affairs. Oh, God, this is terrible. Okay, here we go. First ever. First, I have not listened to this. I have not approved this. This could be terrible. But we're live. We're technically live. I'm not going to cut this out. So here we go. This could be awful. Oh, God, save me.
From the United States or fucking Ireland? Are they from Sao Paulo or the fucking Australian island? Who fucking knows?
Who fucking knows?
Who fucking cares?
Who fucking cares?
Toxic does, cause he's a badass. Keeping them softly is the podcast of global affairs.
Okay, that ending right there is cool, but I don't like the talking at the beginning. It should be singing. We gotta have a singer there. Let's try, because they always give you two, so we'll do the other one. We'll do the other. Yeah. But see, it's see, it's not picking it up right. And that's the thing about AI. And I'll talk to you about that actually while I'm fucking with this. I want to talk to you, because it's almost like on the stream where I just fucking talk about whatever. But the thing is, with AI, a lot of people don't get it. You do, because you're intelligent. The guy from Ireland, the rest of you probably not. But the AI, in getting the use out of AI, be it ChatGPT, Gemini, Runway, fucking Suno, Jammable, whatever you use for your AI purposes, the value is not in immediately getting an answer, but it's how you work with the AI to get to that answer. For instance, I'm not the best at coding Visual Basic in Microsoft Excel, right? I'm a total novice. But with the help of Claude and ChatGPT, I was able to make a fucking macro-laden workbook that was a monster. It did exactly what I needed it to do. It would have taken me a fucking 4-year college degree to get to that point otherwise, and I was able to do it in one day. Okay, so let's do this. We're gonna have a bass guitar solo. So our thing is gonna start out with a bass guitar solo. Bass guitar solo. Okay. Solo. A bass guitar intro. Let's do our bass guitar intro. And then we're gonna call that like verse one, because that's gonna make them sing. If I put verse one as the, you know, the it's a toxic teacher. Camping them softly, where the fucking viewers from. And then we're going to do this right here. And then we're going to do verse two right there as are they from the United States and blah, blah, blah. And then I'm going to make a, I'm going to do a bridge here. So this who fucking knows, who fucking cares is our bridge. But then I'm going to make a chorus here. So I'm going to add to it a little bit. I'm going to add to it's Toxic Teacher and Camping Them Softly. Where are the fucking viewers from? Fucking viewers from. Let's fuck around and find out. Okay, so that, oh, Jesus Christ. This is going to be terrible. Okay, so I'm going to do it in a couple. I'm going to do it in a couple of different genres here. So that is, this is how, this is the magic right here. So we've got our podcast intro jingle was what I gave it as like the genre. So I'm going to do it 80s, glam, metal, aggressive. That's what I'm going to call it. Okay. And then we're going to do a 90s storytelling country. Okay. All right. We're ready for that. We're going to have a version for that. Remember, each one comes up with two. And then we're also going to have a 70s danceable, funky, funk, bassline, falsetto vocals. I'm thinking of the Bee Gees whenever I say that. So now we go through our list here. So we're built up. Nobody is listening to this episode anymore. We're 30 minutes in. We haven't done shit Dead by Daylight related. And we'll see if this one does well, there'll be more of this garbage to come. Okay. So the first one is our podcast intro, jingle, right? So let's go for it and see what happens. Oh, good Lord. Okay. Okay. I'll take it. Yeah.
It's the Toxic Teacher, camping them softly. Where are fucking viewers from? We're about to fucking find out. Find out.
Okay.
Are they from the United States?
Okay.
Fucking Ireland. Are they from Sao Paulo or the fucking Australian island?
Yeah, this one's okay.
Who fucking knows?
Who fucking knows?
Who fucking cares?
Who fucking cares?
Toxic does, cause he's a badass, and camping them softly is the podcast global affair. It's Toxic Teacher.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Softly. Where are fucking viewers from? Let's fuck around and find out.
Okay. That one's kind of cool. I can dig it. But we got more to go through. If you are almost at work, you fucking turn this off. You probably delete it. Toss your phone out the window. Hope somebody doesn't pick it up and listen to the rest of this podcast. We haven't even gotten to Dead by Daylight. We are going to get to it. Don't worry about that, Randy from Sao Paulo. We'll get to you. This is also a podcast jingle, but it sounds like Chris Stapleton. Wah! Hang on. Okay. Okay.
He's a toxic teacher.
Okay.
Camping them softly.
Okay.
Where are fucking viewers from?
I don't know.
We're about to fucking find out.
Okay, are we?
Are they from the United States?
Probably about 60%. A lot, actually.
Are they from Sao Paulo?
There's Randy.
Or the fucking Australian island?
There's a few from there, too.
Who fucking knows?
I do.
Who fucking cares?
I also do.
Toxic does, cause he's a badass.
I am.
And camping them softly is the podcast of global
it is.
Affairs. It's Toxic Teacher and camping softly.
Okay, that one's cool. It's cool, but it's a little low energy. For me, that's low energy. No. Okay, 80s glam metal aggressive. Here we go. Oh, fuck yes. Oh, this is. Oh, God. Oh, God. I don't know.
We're about to fucking find out.
I hope we are, motherfucker. Here we go.
Are they from the United States? A fucking island.
Yeah.
Are they from Sao Paulo?
I don't know.
Fucking Australian island.
Maybe.
Who fucking knows?
I do.
Who fucking cares?
I also do.
Toxic does, cause he's a badass. And camping them softly is a podcast of
global affairs. Oh, yeah, dude.
It's Toxic Teacher and camping.
Oh, dude, yes. Yeah.
Where are the fucking viewers from?
Yeah.
Fuck around and find out.
Oh, shit.
Toxic Teacher and Kevin M. Softly. Where are the fucking viewers?
Dude, that is wild shit right there. That is good shit. Thoroughly good. That's going in my keep pile. My keep pile is full of all kinds of shit. Hang on, let's go. We got the other 80s glam metal aggressive. Hang on, right here. Okay, I dig it. I dig it. Not as good as the first, but it's cool. We'll see what the singer sounds like.
It's the Toxic Teacher.
Oh.
Camping in softly.
Oh, yeah. Dude, this one's good too. What? These are both like, these are both rocking, man. I think the first one may be a little more.
From the United States.
Yes.
Fucking Ireland.
Yes, quite a few actually.
Are they from Sao Paulo?
Randy.
Or the fucking Australian island?
Yes.
Who fucking knows?
I do.
Who fucking cares?
I also do.
Toxic does, cause he's a badass.
I am.
And Kevin and Softly is the podcast of global.
It is. This one's good, but it's slow. That's
it's
the only.
Toxic Teacher and Kevin and Softly.
No, I can't. This one, the chorus doesn't like hit. Okay, 90s country. I'm gonna go through them a little quicker. So.
It's a Toxic Teacher. Camping them softly.
No.
Where are fucking viewers from?
This is like where that AI it sounds too AI.
Are they from the United States?
This is not storytelling country.
Ireland.
This is not country.
Are they from Sao Paulo?
You're not country.
Fucking Australian
this
island.
Is not country music.
Who fucking knows?
This is not country
who
music.
Fucking cares?
I care it's not country.
Toxic does because he's a badass.
This,
and Camping Them Softly is a podcast of global
this
affairs.
Is not country music.
It's Toxic Teacher.
Stop. This is, I don't know what that is. It sounds like a southern. Okay. Here's the other one. This sounds more like country. Hang on. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Right? Right?
It's the Toxic Teacher.
Okay.
Camping them softly.
Yeah.
Where are fucking viewers from?
Yeah.
We're about to fucking find out.
Are we?
Are they from the United States?
Why does it drop
Ireland?
A beat?
Are they from South
this,
Paulo?
It was country at first.
Fucking Australian island.
Who I, fucking knows? Who
why
fucking
is it a
cares?
Duet?
Toxic does because he's a badass.
I have no fucking idea what's happening.
Of global affairs.
It's Toxic Teacher.
No.
And
I can't. No.
Softly,
no. No. Okay, so the only potential other is going to be our 70s danceable funky bassline falsetto vocals. Here we go. Let's take it away. Version one. Okay, what do we feel? I'm feeling good so far. Hang on.
It's a toxic teacher camping them softly.
Oh, this one's good.
Where are fucking viewers from? We're about to fucking find out.
Yeah.
Are they from the United States or fucking Ireland?
Who knows?
Are they from Sao Paulo or the fucking Australian island? Who fucking knows?
This one's good, dude.
Cares?
I'm what do they say? Vibing, I think is what it's called. Okay, yeah. Let's okay, of course.
Toxic Teacher and Camping Them Softly.
Oh yeah.
Where are the fucking viewers from? Let's fuck around and find out. It's Toxic Teacher and Camping Them Softly.
I dig it. I dig it.
Where are the fucking viewers from? Let's fuck around and find out.
Oh yeah. Now we're gonna. Are we gonna have like a little breakdown? Oh yeah. Okay, that's it.
It's a toxic teacher.
This one, that one's close. I think I like the glam metal more. And then let's go to version two of the danceable funky funk bass line falsetto vocals. That wasn't even falsetto vocals, but I'm not going to hold it against him. Okay, version two now. Okay, this one's even more funky. I dig that. I dig it. More funky.
It's the toxic teacher camping them softly. Where
okay.
Are fucking viewers from? We're about to fucking find out.
It's okay.
Are they from the United States?
Oh, fucking Ireland, bitch. Oh, South dude, I should have put bitch in there. Huh. Who fucking knows? I fucking care. Oh, see, I could actually overlay my voice on this. Where are the fucking viewers from? No, that one's not doing it for me. That one's not doing it for me. So I think we've got our two winners. Was the danceable funky funk falsetto vocals version one, and then also the first 80s glam metal was by far, that was the best one that we came up with. So guys, thank you for your patience and for your
you gotta give him that huck too and spit on that thing, you get me?
Yeah, thank you. Oh god. So like I said, at some point we're gonna get to Dead by Daylight. It's going to happen. I'm not exactly sure when, but it is going to happen. And I think the first thing we have to do though is we didn't even start it, is to talk about our viewers. But we've got an intro now. So fuck it.
Who fucking cares?
Here we go. See? Okay, let's go to our fucking viewers. Hang on, right here.
It's Toxic Teacher and Camping Me Softly. Where are the fucking
viewers from?
Let's
do it. Okay, we're about to fucking find out. Yeah, okay. Anyway, yeah, we're done. Ooh, that was high energy. Okay, now I gotta fucking get to the website. See, I can kill energy. I'm a professional energy killer. So episode number 22, was it 22? I think I've got a few on here that are interesting and slightly, I think interesting might be the best word for it. We've got a lot of our returners here. Mitch and Merton, you're back. That's good to see. Beaufort, South Carolina, I think you're back. Newark, New Jersey is always a pretty loyal listener. Troy from Michigan. No, it's not Troy from Michigan. It's Troy, Michigan. Thank you. Denver, Colorado, Memphis, Tennessee, Antrim in Newton Abbey, Hasselt in Limburg Province, Reykjavik in Iceland is back. Thank you, Reykjavik. Leinster in Dublin, my biggest fan. Like, if I ever come to Ireland, like, I need to meet this person. Although I might be frightened, so I'm a little scared. Parsons, Tennessee, thanks for coming by. Rockland, Ontario, thank you for coming by. I hope you know Mr. Swift Kick from, what was that, like episode 11 or 12? The Canadian streamer. Battleboro, Vermont, sounds amazing. El Paso, Texas, right there on the border with Mexico. And now you're not gonna believe this shit. I wish I had a drum roll. Can I get one here? Hang on. Let me type in drum roll here. Drum roll. Is there a drum roll? Yes. There is a drum roll, and I need to download that one, by the way, actually. Hang on. I'm going to download it. Put it in my keep pile. It's going on my keep pile with all my other shit. All right. So, back to it. The city you will not believe is Baghdad, Iraq.
Do I think you could beat my ass? Hell
this is
no.
Not right.
Do I think I could beat your ass? Why, hell yeah.
That was not the right one. I told you, this folder just has like random name, like a desert.
Comparatively speaking, you are like a grain of sand in the Sahara Desert. Yeah, and I am the entire desert.
Okay, that's strangely fitting. But yeah, Baghdad, Iraq. I have somebody in a fucking war zone listening to this podcast. Think about that for a good long time as to why in the middle of a war zone. I have to dodge these bullets and then I need to listen to somebody pulling this shit. What? It's not playing.
Oh, sexy girlfriend.
That's what they got to listen to in the middle of the Middle East. A war zone. Listening to fucking...
Oh, sexy girlfriend.
Listen, I thank you, but please stay safe in Baghdad, Iraq. Iraq, Iraq. See, I don't even know. I remember the first Gulf War with Saddam. Do you remember that? Nobody remembers that shit. See, this is where it gets hard as an older content creator that none of my references fucking even matter anymore. Like everybody else is just fucking, they're going about their merry way. And I've got all these old ass, like where's my fucking, hardly anyone knows what that is anymore. Like, and nobody knows what this
You're
is.
You're not down with that. We got two words for you.
Like some people might, some of you, the fans of the wrestling there may know what that is. But anyway, I want to thank you, Baghdad. And I also want to ask Samuel A.I. Jackson, stay in character. Can you tell me why someone in Bag, B-A-G-H-D-I-D, Iraq, would in their right mind want to listen to my podcast, Camping Them Softly? Okay, that's, I'm just straight up going to ask a question because I can't talk to the Baghdadi. I think that's right. Baghdadi. I'm your Baghdadi. That's probably offensive to somebody now that I think about it. But anyway, let's figure out why they would want to listen.
Why the wouldn't someone in Baghdad want to listen to Camping Them Softly, huh? Maybe they're out there dodging craziness all day and just need to kick back, relax, and hear some Dead by Daylight talk that's straight up badass.
That's quite a compliment.
They're probably tired of the same old sh**, and your podcast is like a breath of fresh, toxic air.
Fresh.
Who doesn't need a little gaming escape mixed with some dark humor, no matter where they're at?
Fresh, toxic air. I love it. Fresh. Smell it. Oh, sniff it. Do you smell that fucking... this is the worst. This is the worst podcast episode ever. Okay, here. Why? Okay, so here we go. Get this. This is where the fun starts. Why would someone in Iraq not want to listen to Camping Them Softly? Okay, are you ready for this? Question mark. Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay. Okay, here we go. Ready?
Well, let me break it down for you. Maybe they're too busy handling real life shit to care about a game where some dude's trying to shank you in the fog.
Yeah, that's true.
Or maybe they're not into Dead by Daylight or don't get all the niche jokes and
I don't make niche jokes. My jokes are for everybody.
They might just not vibe with the whole laid-back Western-style podcast.
Western-style?
Different strokes for different folks, right?
This is not a Western-style podcast.
Not everyone's into that kind of thing.
Why the fuck would you think it's a...
That's a whole lot more serious than gaming.
No, you quit this.
But hey, your podcast isn't for everyone.
Yes, it is.
And that's what makes it stand out.
Mother Fusher. Okay, so now I'm starting to get mad here. It's not for everyone. I disagree. This podcast. Hey there. Calm down, Sam. This podcast is for everyone. Get it straight, dude. Okay, we'll see what he has to say. Now, see, this is getting kind of. Okay, here we go. Yeah. Oh, here we go.
All right, I got you. Your podcast is for everyone.
It is, yes, thank you.
Whether they're out in Iraq or chilling anywhere else,
yes,
everyone deserves a taste of that Camping Them Softly goodness.
Finally, somebody sees it.
They're not on board yet. They just don't know what they're missing, motherfucker.
Whoa, shit, motherfrasher. Okay, there we go. All right, so how do you say Camping Them Softly? How do you say Camping Them Softly in Arabic? Oh, this is gonna. Oh, this is gonna be interesting here. Okay. I don't even know if it's gonna tell me. Can it, unlike ChatGPT? Oh my God. Oh, we've got it. Oh shit. Is it gonna say it?
All right. Here's how you say camping them softly in Arabic. At-tahim bihudu.
At-tahim bihudu.
Even in Arabic, your podcast's name's got that vibe.
At-tahim bihudu. Bihudu. All right. Hang on.
Here's how you say camping them softly in Arabic. At-tahim bihudu.
At-tahim bihudu. All right. This is so fucking stupid. I'm sorry, everybody. We've got to talk about fucking Dead by Daylight. But I need a song for, like, now we got to talk about the game type shit, right? What about this one?
I'm your friend.
That's not it. I don't have a sound for, like, hey, let's get on the topic. Do I have one? Hang on. I'm looking. I'm trying to look quickly because I know you're done with me. And scary children choir. I don't know what that is. Scary laughing. Seductive. Shut hole. Smelly pirate hooker. I'm just going through my sounds here. Stupid insult. Suck it too. Taste bad. Oh, Jesus Christ.
That tastes like ass.
I don't even know why that's in here. I don't remember that. Although I do want to use this one more. Okay, nobody knows what that is. That's fucking okay. So let's, I have nothing. I really have absolutely nothing. So I can use my like news one, I guess. Let's talk about Dead by fucking Daylight. Even though I'm not too excited about it, we'll fucking talk about it. So anyway, guys, there's not a lot going on in Dead by Daylight right now. Just my opinion. There's not a whole lot going on. I did get the chance to play some Dracula. And overall, he's one of those killers. He takes a bit more juggling of things to get right. I played him on stream. If you go check the last stream, he's on there. Because you're having to juggle between his, like, hellfire and the bats and the wolf, it's very active in that sense. So it's a lot like Vecna. It's a lot like the other killers where you're having to juggle abilities and use the right one at the right time. And, you know, you can easily lose if you make a couple of bad decisions. If you're using the hellfire when you shouldn't be, or you're not using the bats effectively. That is one of the biggest complaints. And I feel like it's going to be really hard to balance that because there's such a skill gap there between those who cannot use Dracula effectively and those who can use him very effectively. Is who do you balance that killer for? Because if you balance it for the one that's great, that'll probably make him, like, totally unusable or very underpowered for the person who's just an average player. Now, if you make it to where the average player can use him effectively, probably a high MMR player can steamroll people. And so you're going to have that same issue both ways. And probably either way, the survivors are going to cry about it. That's just what they do, right? So that's kind of where I stand on it. Trevor, Spaghetti Arms, I don't know. We talked about that, Spaghetti Arms McGee or whatever fucking, that was on the stream as well. We were talking about Spaghetti Arms, or I was looking, I think that was, yeah, that was on the last one because we were talking, I was asking Sam AI Jackson for some nicknames. And then, so he came up with Spaghetti Arms. Yes, it's all coming. I'm Celine Dion. It's all coming back to me now. But yeah, we tried that. I have nothing big to say about Trevor's abilities. It's all going to shake out whenever it goes live. In what way? Not 100% sure. But yeah, we've got that. We also put up some artwork. One of my viewers said, let's make a song about Dracula. And then they said, make a song about Dracula, but in a bikini. And so we went down this AI fucking music rabbit hole, just like we did today, of, okay, now let's put Dracula in a bikini. Now, what genre is it? And what if we put him in fucking roller skates? And then it keeps going and going and going. And yeah, that's it went to crazy places. And I don't know where my Dracula in a Bikini song is, because I had it pulled up. I don't think I downloaded it. Oh shit, did I delete it? No, I didn't. Oh, if I did, I'm gonna be very sad. I'm gonna be really sad. I wonder if I did. I might have accidentally delete. Oh no, that's sad. Because I had it and it was great and it fucking, hang on, what if I search? I think you could search on here, Dracula. Search it. There it is. Oh my God, is this it? Is this it, Dracula in a Bikini? I think this was it. In the fog of death, I take it. No. No. In the fog of no. Was this it? I think it might have been. I have to fast forward. And he's ready to bite. But forget the cake. No, that wasn't it. Was it this? Dracula's here and no. Hang on. Stalking in the shadows when eyes are blue. No, that's not it. I know this is. But this ain't your grandma's cape and fangs. Yeah, I think he's rocking a bikini with some real sharp fangs. This might be it. Yeah, this is fucking it right here. He's stalking in the shadows, red eyes aglow. But when he steps out, it's a fashion show. Forget the castle, he's here to stay. Yeah. Selling skins and game. Behavior's payday. Because bikini slashing through the night with every stylish move. He's here to buy us a fright. He's got the looks. He's got the bite. Yeah. Now, I remember why we got into this talk was because I was playing with the fucking Sable skin where she got the ears and the fucking dragon wings. I'm like, dude, they're making money hand over fist so they can make casting a Frank Stone project team, whatever, God knows, whatever other game. They're going to resurrect one of their old games. I don't even know what Behavior did 20 years ago. But with the money they're making off of bare feet and fucking bras, they can afford to fucking resurrect every game they've ever made. And it's only going to get worse from here, I think. Behavior Interactive Game List. What is their game list? Here, Game Portfolio. Does this go all the way back? I want it to go all the way back. I want, like, as far back as we can get on these games here. So they did fucking Alvin and the Chipmunks. They did Brave. They did Planes, Disney Planes for the Wii U. They could bring that back. They could also bring back Rango. They did a lot of Disney games. I did not know that. They did the Transformers games. They also did Nickelodeon Victorious Hollywood Arts debut. They could bring that back. Westworld. They had a Westworld video game. Are you serious? Oh, God, no. It was a Westworld, like, a mobile game. It was like a, it almost looks like, I think I remember this. Wasn't this a copy of Fallout? What's the Fallout mobile game? It was a Fallout Shelter, right? Hang on, let me Google that. Fallout Shelter. Hang on, why don't we just ask Sam? Hey, what's the deal with the Westworld mobile game? Wasn't there a controversy about it? Question mark. Okay. And let's see what Sam says. Yep. Here. That's it. That's it. I fucking knew it. I knew it. And see, I'm a genius. See, I don't forget shit. Sam, tell him what I'm talking about.
Oh yeah. There was some serious drama with the Westworld mobile game and it wasn't pretty. Motherfucker. So here's
exactly
back in 2018, the developers of the Westworld mobile game got slapped with a lawsuit from Bethesda, the creators of Fallout Shelter.
See, I told you.
Bethesda claimed that the Westworld game used the exact same code as Fallout Shelter.
See?
And they weren't just talking about similarities. They meant literally the same code, bugs and all.
See?
The controversy blew up when it was discovered that both games were developed by the same studio, Behavior Interactive.
See?
Bethesda accused them of recycling their code, which was a huge breach of contract. the lawsuit was settled out of court, and the Westworld game got pulled from app stores in early 2019.
Oh, shit.
That game got nuked faster than a vault in Fallout, and the whole thing left a bad taste in a lot of gamers' mouths.
Oh, shit. That is wild. That is wild shit.
Gotta give him that huck. Spit on that thing.
Yeah, okay. I didn't know Behavior Interactive was in a lawsuit with fucking Bethesda over a shady ass business. I'm never going to be a fog whisperer now. I'm an investigative journalist, by the way. Just FYI.
Ahoy, ladies. Didn't see you there. Would you guys like to set sail on this ocean of flavor with me? I'll be your captain. I'm Steve Harrington.
Now, so going back to Dracula in a bikini, is put a bikini on them, dude. They can afford to settle out of court. They could buy Bethesda if they put Dracula in a bikini. Put a bikini skin on every single fucking killer, and boom, millions. Why am I not on their marketing team? I'm not gonna get fucking sued by Bethesda. I mean, I could tell you that. Don't use the same code from one game to code another fucking game. That'd be like if they somebody comes and says, hey, make me an asymmetrical horror game. Hey guys, let's just put the same fucking shit from Dead by Daylight in there, make it just as laggy as it was before, and then try to sell it as something else. That shit ain't gonna work. Anyway, that's that. You would think, hey, does he not have like a sound for the end that's way too loud?
Let's do all the things that you want to do.
Of course I do. I can finish every single sentence with a sound alert.
You got some kick-ass shit.
If I really wanted to. I don't want to, but I will if I need to.
Brother, I was at Arby's scarfing down a chicken cordon bleu. That natural chicken tastes righteous. That's because it's not all pumped up with phosphates and fillers.
Okay, so that's that. That's interesting. That just blows me away. I did not know that was Behavior. I remember that when that happened, that lawsuit. But I did not know that was Behavior. So that's okay. Pretty cool. That'll get you banned on the Behavior forums if you bring that up, more than likely. So I would probably not do that. So let me take a look here. Is on the DBD forums. I was, you know what I do. You know what I do. I goof around. I check the forums. I study the survivors. And I'm always watching. I'm always trying to figure out what's going on with these people, with these survivors. Because I need to know. I need to know about you guys. So there's somebody here that says, I don't even know. It says there is a decent way to implement Basekit Unbreakable. Talking about Basekit Unbreakable. Think about that. Remember, they talked about that a long time ago. But they're the Basekit Unbreakable. Do you know how terrible that would be? I think you do know how terrible, and you're waiting for the sound alert, but you're not going to get it because I'm going to go into it. Oh my God, dude. Okay. So here we go. I'm going to read this. There are no comments. I saw this and I saw Basekit Unbreakable, and so my eyes just went to it. I haven't read the whole thing yet, so I don't know what my reaction is going to be. I don't know if this is a killer or survivor main, so it remains to be seen. So here we go. I think most people can generally agree that Basekit Unbreakable PTB proved the idea to be not very healthy for the game if implemented as it was. However, I don't think the concept is unsalvageable. I'm going to take the stance that you got to be really careful where you walk from here, because there's very limited cases in which I would be okay with Basekit Unbreakable. They're very limited. I'm struggling off the top of my head to think when that would be good. So let's keep going. An issue that's been plaguing the game for a while now is the 2-versus-1 stalemate situation, in which two survivors are already dead, leaving the killer to search for the remaining two while they hide without repairing generators. Okay. So I'm going to bounce off of what he said. I've had this happen a few times. I wouldn't say it's like endemic. I don't think it's plaguing the game. He says like a fucking plague of locusts trying to destroy the game. I don't think that I don't
there's
see
there's someone on the way. Some thing.
Nobody knows what that's from either. But so that like no, it's not plaguing the game, but let's keep going. I am not anti this person yet, okay? So what they say is the problem is that if the killer wants to go for four kills, they have to slug one while searching for the other in order to prevent the hatch from spawning. That's correct. That's 100% right. They're on the money. Thank you for saying something intelligent on the DBD behavior forum. You deserve a round of applause for that. A smart thing was said on behaviors. Okay, anyway, let's keep going. Okay, so you have to slug to get the other, and then you get the 4K, right? Okay, it says this can be considered to be slow, undesirable gameplay. I would say probably. Yes, it's not. The killer doesn't necessarily enjoy doing it. The survivors hate it. And they're going to hate that. Remember, didn't they have something where like if you down them, it mories them automatically or something like that? I don't remember if this would be one of those situations because I can't remember that whole like insta-mori aspect, but I'll have to go back and look at that. But it says, okay, so here's what the dude says. I think this situation would be a perfect place to implement the base kit unbreakable mechanic. Okay. Let's see what he says. I'm not even going to change my voice for him because he hasn't gone overboard yet. I'm restraining myself. I'm holding back as best as possible. Let's keep going. If survivors could pick themselves up off the ground after two survivors have been killed/sacrificed, a lot of the issues of this stalemate would go away. I'm going to pause there. My problem with that is it, how's a killer ever going to get a fucking 4K in this situation? There's no way. You would have to down somebody and down the other one. You would have to give an unbreakable timer of 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes. Give me something to find that fourth person. Because if that fourth person's got some stealth perks, got distortion, got fucking iron will, got everything they need to conceal themselves, and I down you, and I'm looking for them. If you've got a 60 second unbreakable timer, I'm never gonna get four kills. That's fucking bananas. So I'm getting a little antsy here. But he may have some logic. Okay, he or she may have some logic. Logic? Easy for me to say. Easy for me to fucking say. Okay, so let's keep going. Killers would be unable to effectively slug for four kills and would have to commit to sacrificing one survivor and look for hatch. While this would make certain challenges that require going for four kills less consistent, there are hatch offerings that can mitigate this. First off, you shouldn't have to have a hatch offering to mitigate this. Bullshit. Number two, that is a certain challenges, like he's talking about the challenges in the tomes, but that's going to make getting four kills near very unlikely, not impossible, but unlikely. And I think that that's a net negative. Now, here's what the person says to kind of conclude their argument. The only missing component is that there would need to be some system in place in order to prevent the last two survivors from hiding indefinitely without repairing any generators. That's what you said in the first fucking place was the problem. It wasn't the problem of the slugging. It was the problem of the hiding was the problem. Okay, this is survivor main. You can tell it's a fucking survivor main by how they're acting. So, okay, so I'm almost done here. I'm starting to get, you can tell the reaction change a little bit. Perhaps idle crows should trigger more frequently after two survivors have died. That's a possibility. That's something. But I do agree. I do agree on one of the two main points this person makes. Number one, that two survivors hiding is a problem. slugging is not, because if you want 4K, you got to do it. If I want 4K, I got to slug one, get the other. Do I normally do that? No, I will not typically do that unless they piss me off in some way, unless I'm salty in some way, unless I woke up on the wrong side of the toxic waterbed, because I still have one of those big ass waterbeds. You know, the waterbeds with like the big wooden frame that weighs like 7,000 pounds. I want one of those, and I'm going to pretend I've got one just for the purposes of this joke.
The first thing I want you to do is shut your stinking hole.
That's what she said.
Okay, there we go. So that, you know, that's all I got to say about that. I think there's got to be a better way. There has to be some kind of detection if a gen doesn't get touched for X number of minutes, something happens. That I think that might be fair. If there's no chase, let's say that, because I think it can tell, right, if there's a chase. If there's no chase, number one, if there's no chase. Number two, if I just lost my fucking train of thought. What was I saying? What the fuck was I saying? If there's no chase and if no Jane gets done, something happens. I don't know. Kill him. Fuck him. Like, what? Whatever, like it makes something happen to keep the game moving. I don't know what that is. Make them injured. Injure them if they don't do something. Fucking
do it. Give them that huck too and spit on that thing.
Yeah, you do that to them. I don't know. It doesn't fucking matter. But just, I agree. I agree halfway with this person. And we'll leave it there. There was nothing that was just so shocking that I could easily find in the 10 minutes I spent prepping that I had to bring. And then there was nothing big over the last week that just needed to be called out. So that was pretty much it, man. You know, we've got that Five Nights at fucking Freddy's, the cartoon Dead by Daylight's coming. And then we've also got, you know, Dracula, the Castlevania chapter is going to go live later this month. We also talked about the roadmap in the next couple of months. So there's going to be some changes, hopefully some positive changes. We'll see where they go with that. And, you know, just keep plugging along, keep playing, you know, get through your Rift Homes. I always buy mine out because I'm not patient enough and I don't play enough to make that fucking kind of thing happen. Oh, by the way, also Hunt Showdown, which is a game I very much like. I've streamed it a few times, is, as of the time of this recording, I think tomorrow, the 16th, coming out with like a remake, a remaster of some kind called Hunt 1896. I'm gonna have to check that shit out. Also been playing a little bit of Warframe. I don't know that I'm gonna be able to get back into it because that's a fucking slog. And then also been playing a lot more Rocksmith Plus, and then I also re-downloaded my original Rocksmith for all the custom DLC. So I've been playing some bass guitar on there. By the way, if you need some good bass guitar music, if you check out, hang on, because this is not a monetized podcast, I could probably play a little bit. If you check out the song, you know, some of you guys may not know the Brothers Johnson. I know some of you might. If you're older or if you're like a music person, you probably know the Brothers Johnson. And there's one song, oh shit, because I was goofing around with it last night. Oh God, it's not Get the Funk Out of My Face. It's Ain't We Funkin' Now. That, hey, if you want a good bass guitar song, right here, this shit, right here. Yeah, check it. Hang on. See, you feel that bass right there? Here. Yeah, that right there. Yeah, Ain't We Funkin' Now. That's a good one, though. Check that one out if you can. Guys, I think that's about it for this week. Hey, I apologize. Past couple of weeks have been so bananas. The schedule has just been out of whack here at the Toxic Casa de Toxic, I guess. Is it Toxico? I think it's Toxico. Casa de Toxico. Anyway, guys, I appreciate it. Hey, keep coming. Send me an email. Send me a Twitch message. Send me a text message. I believe you can text now on any of the platforms on Spotify. Leave me a shitty comment. Rate me 5 stars. Go on to YouTube. Subscribe. The Toxic Teacher. You can find me on all the socials. Toxic Teacher TTV. That's X. That's Twitter and X. And that's also Instagram. And that's also TikTok. And that's also Threads, I think, is even a thing, right? Is Threads still a thing? I think it is a thing. I know a lot of people are trying to get big on that. But you can find me on all that shit or send me an email, thetoxicteacher@gmail.com. If you want to be on the show, if you're interested in being a guest or if you're interested in being an enemy or a friend or a frenemy or a frenemy or an economy or whatever you want, you can do it if you only believe in yourself here at Camping Them Softly. And without further ado, guys, get the... See, I'm going to get quiet. See, fuck out of my face. Oh, yeah. Hey, that was good. Hang on. Oh, okay.
Just kicking asses low and high. His toxic reign of terror begins. When toxic can't, he always wins. Survivors tremble, shit explodes.